So here inside program class, going to create method of public void, and here method name giving sum. So see at here, if I'm not going to include access specifier, so let's execute. So at here, no any error I got. So you can give or you can not give, it's your chance. And hereafter, right here, I'm going to take integer variable int a, comma, b, comma, c. Now hereafter, writing console class dot write line method. So right here, going to write at here enter two numbers. So first is for a equal to int dot parse console dot read line, and here after b equal to int dot parse console dot read line. Now hereafter let's do add opposite, c equal to a plus b, and hereafter console class dot write line method here sum equal to c. So this is the method at here. Method. So this is the block of a statement. And let's go inside the main method. So here I'm going to create the object of program class p1 equal to name program. And p1 that called a sum method, and here after console dot readline. So let's execute the code. So I enter the two numbers. So first I'm going to enter 7 here, 6. 7 plus 6, the value comes 18. So by using method, we add two numbers at here. So this is sum. Here you can give any parameter. I will show you in upcoming or later. And hereafter, this is method body. Here I did to block a statement. And let's understand how the program works. So if you debug the code, control comes to main method. Hereafter, I create the object of program class p1. Here p1.sum. So this called by the help of p1 object that called a sum method. So hereafter control comes to this point. So sum that receive hereafter that go inside. So right here I have taken three integer variable abc console dot write time. So this display into the output script, and whatever I am going to enter, so that receive by a and b. And hereafter if I suppose if I enter a value at here 7 and b value at here 6, 7 plus 6 the value come 13, console dot write time sum equal to 13 that display. So here sum method part has been over. So now that back here console.readline. So this take one input from keyword and commit the output. This is the first example of method in sysr.net. So in method you can give parameter as well. So first I'm going to delete this one so it's not required. And here this one as well. So this is a method public void send. So here I'm going to give two parameters. So you can give one parameter, two parameter according to programming requirement. So here I have taken two parameter. Now here after writing console class dot write line method. So right here sum equal to P plus Q. Now, after that, so go inside to main method. So actually, I'm going to create program class object P1 equal to new program, and here P1 dot sub. So this time we need to pass the two parameter values of P and Q. So actually, I'm going to enter 2m here 7. So this is the simplest code, very short code to add two numbers by using method. So let's execute and check. So at here sum equal to 19, 12, 7, at here 19, that's display. So getting the expected output. So let's understand how the program works. So if you debug the code, control comes to main method, here after that coincide. So at here I created program class object P1. So p1.sum, so that called sum method. So at here that control comes to this time. So at here p value is now 12, q value 7. So hereafter that coincides. So at here console.writer. So this displayed to the output screen, and here p plus q 12 plus 7 19. So sum equal to 19, that display. Now hereafter I'm going to show you the third ways to add two numbers. So at here this is not required, and I'm going to remove the parameter. So in place of void, you can include integer, float, double, whatever. So I included at your integer. So at your this also not required. So since I included at your integer, so we need to give at your return of value. So if you include integer double, so you should use return keyword also. So let's see. So at here I'm going to take integer variable a, b, and here console dot write line. At here enter two numbers. So at here a equal to int dot parse console dot read line. Here b equal to int dot parse console dot read line. Now hereafter let's use return keyword return, so that return a plus b value. Now hereafter let's go inside main method. So at here I'm going to create the object of program class of p1 by using new keyword program. Now hereafter taking integer variable c, and here c that call p1 sum method, and here let's use console dot write line, and here sum equal to plus c, that display. So this is the code to add two numbers. So this time using int. So let's execute and check. So enter two numbers. So at here I'm going to enter 7 and 4. So 7 plus 4, the value comes 11. So this is the third ways to add two numbers in sysop.net. So let's understand the code. So at here, if any of debug the code, control comes to main method, hereafter that coincides. So at here I created p1 object of program class, and here c int c equal to p1.sum. So p1 object that called sum method. So hereafter that control comes to this point. Here I've taken two integer variable a, b. So this display into the output screen, and here what I'm going to enter, so that asset by a and b. So a value I enter at here of 7, and b value I'm going to enter at here 4. So hereafter return a plus b. So 7 plus 4, the value comes 11. So this value is now at here 11. So this return 11. Now hereafter control back to this point. So this value is now 11. So this value 11 at here. So 11 go to c, and hereafter console dot write line. So sum equal to c value is now 11, so that is it. And here after console dot return, so this take one input from keyword and terminate the output screen. Now hereafter I am going to show you the fourth way to add two numbers. So right here this is not required, and here I am going to pass the parameter. So right here I am going to pass the parameter int pair and int keyer. Now hereafter that coincides, so right here return p plus q value. Now hereafter to get the object, and here going to take integer variable int a comma b comma c. Now hereafter console dot write line, so and here enter two number. So this are displayed into the output screen. Here a equal to int dot parse console dot read line. Now hereafter b equal to int dot parse console dot read line. Now hereafter c1. Sorry, c equal to that called p1 object dot operator sum method. So at here we need to pass a or b, and here after console dot write line, so we need to write sum equal to and here plus value of c. So this is the code to add two numbers. So this time using here int and return, and this is the fourth base. So let's execute the code. So enter the two numbers. So enter, I enter 6 here, 3. So 6 plus 3, the value come 9. And let's understand how the program works. So if you debug the code, control comes to main method. Hereafter that coincides, so at here I created program class object p1 by using leetcode keyword. Hereafter taken three integer variable abc, so this are displayed into the output screen console.writeline. And here whatever I am going to enter, so that is for a and b. So at here I am going to enter a value 6 and b value at here 3. Now hereafter c equal to p1 dot sum, so a at here 6, b at here 3. So p1 object that called sum method, so hereafter control comes to this point. So at here p receive at here 6 here, or this receive 3. So at here that coincide return p plus q, so 6 plus 3 welcome 9, so 9 return. So hereafter that go back, so this value is now at here 9. So 9 go to c, and hereafter console dot write line sum equal to, so that print value of 9. Hereafter that take one input for q and terminate the output.